Hello guys! I just made a giant hungry robot which can eat literally everything. If you subscribe to my channel, you might know this hungry robot which was fully made by 3D printer. This time, I'm not gonna use 3D printer at all. I'm also not gonna use Arduino. In fact, instead of Arduino, I'm gonna use Robotis control board, which is easier than Arduino. In this video, I'm gonna show you how I built this robot. Let's get started. I bought a basket for a main body from Klaus Olsen. I also bought a small basket for hands of the robot. You may use a pack of milk or something like that. I taped a small basket on the handle of the basket and tested it briefly. It seemed working. These are the things you need to prepare. I'm gonna share all the link in the below description as usual. This is the servo motor which is called Robotis Dynamic Cell. This is very smart and strong, so the robot easily lifts any stuff on his hand. This is the servo controller board, which is called CM930. This board has an awesome function for servo motors. Once you see how it deals with servo motors, you must like this company. The robot will use 12 volts for its power, so I prepared the SMPS, but later I'm gonna use a lithium battery. This is a distance sensor, and this sensor also used in the previous robot project. Instead of using 3D printer, I'm gonna use hot melt glue and duct tape. Let's make a room for a servo motor. I simply measured its size and cut the basket with a cutter. As I expected, it wasn't fit well, so I adjusted them a few times. I temporarily fixed it with the duct tape and put a large amount of hot melt glue to secure them together. I also used the duct tape to fix the small basket with the handle. This is kind of most important moment of this project because this part moves handle. The white thing I attach to the servo motor is called horn. It connects other parts with the servo motor. We need to secure them firmly, so I used a very large amount of hot melt glue, which looks very professional. They look a little bit ugly, but well, they work. It's time to assemble circuit things together. This is the distance sensor, which uses infrared light. The sensor will tell the controller how far the object is from the body. In order for the robot to see if there's something is inside of his hand, the robot must have a sensor. You may use other ways to check, but I used this way because this is very easy. I connected the sensor with port number 1 on the controller. You may need to remember the port number because we need to read the port status in the program. I also put the other cable, which is from the servo motor, on the controller. I tested it briefly with a manager program for the servo motor. This is another important thing to make because this part lifts the lid. In order to make it work, I used a plastic stick. It didn't work well, so I had to put one more link between the arm and lid. Let's take a look how I finished the hardware for a while. Let me show you how I programmed and downloaded its code into the controller. Basically, in order to use the servo motor, we need to change its ID number. I changed the ID number as number 1. I used Robot Plus Manager for it. A robot company called Robotis is very good at these kind of things. You may refer to the website. You can also test it like this instantly. Here is the main program I used for the overall system. Its name is R+task. As you can see, with this program, you can put some logic into the robot. It uses its own language rather than C++ or something like complex programming language. For the beginners, this is good for learn how logical programs are made. Because I wanted to see a distance data from the sensor, I temporarily made a monitor program like what we do with an Arduino serial monitor. Let me show you the code and how I made it. Its logic is quite simple. When sensor data is over than a threshold value, rotate the servo motor in a certain amount of angle. Then wait for a short time and then rotate the servo back to the initial angle. When you are ready to download the code, press the download button and wait for a second. Then the robot is ready to go. Lastly, I put the eyes on the lid for fun. It was nice and fun to build this robot. Moreover, it was easier than Arduino. If you want to see more fun and inspiring projects, consider to subscribe my channel. I will see you next time with my another project. Bye. 안녕.